So you want to use the antechamber? Then come along on this journey into the glove box. The antechamber is the gateway through which all chemicals, supplies, and equipment must pass through to get into or back out of the glove box. Think about it like the airlock on a space station or in a submarine. An airlock protects the inside of the space station from exposure to the vacuum of space. Our antechamber protects the glove box from the oxygen and humidity that can destroy our sensitive chemistry. First things first, let's take a look at all the parts of a glove box's antechamber. Our antechamber is really just a simple metal cylinder. The outer door and the inner door are circular metal plates at the ends of the cylinder, and they're connected through hinges or hooks on metal posts that lock them in place. There's a valve at the bottom that can allow nitrogen gas in from the glove box or evacuate the chamber using an attached vacuum pump. Finally, a vacuum gauge sits on top of the cylinder, indicating the level of vacuum inside the chamber. The vacuum gauge uses a black needle to indicate the level of vacuum. The far right side is the zero position, which means there's no vacuum present. In other words, it's at normal atmospheric pressure. As vacuum is introduced, the needle moves counterclockwise, eventually coming to rest just shy of 30 inches of mercury. That's the red scale. When gas is allowed back into the antechamber, the gauge moves clockwise towards zero. When you come into lab, you'll commonly find the antechamber looking like this. The gauge indicates it's under vacuum, and the black valve is positioned vertically. In this position, the valve is neither open to vacuum nor is it open to nitrogen. The antechamber is a sealed vessel from both the inside of the glove box and the outside. The words evacuate and refill indicate the positions that you would turn the valve. Moving towards refill brings nitrogen gas in through the stainless steel tubing that comes straight from the main glove box. Moving the valve toward evacuate opens the antechamber to the vacuum pump through some straight stainless steel and flexible stainless steel tubing. Here's a very important point. Whenever the antechamber is evacuated, do not try to open the doors or even turn the knobs. You can do some serious damage to the door while it's under vacuum. If you want to bring something through the antechamber must be at atmospheric pressure before opening either door. Turn the valve to refill until the vacuum gauge reaches zero. Then turn the valve back to the vertical or neutral position. You're now able to open the door and fill the antechamber with whatever needs to be transferred. Let's assume you're bringing something into the glove box from the outside. Turn the doorknob counterclockwise about a full turn until the door can be lifted up off its support post. Let the door hang while you place your stuff inside. With your stuff inside, swing the door back onto the support post, turn the doorknob until you feel that it's firm but not too tight, and then start with your first evacuation cycle. Each evacuation cycle will be 5 minutes. So set a timer and find something else to do. After 5 minutes are up, you can refill the antechamber with fresh nitrogen gas and begin your second evacuation cycle. Here's another important point. Notice the vacuum gauge as Nick does the refill. It never reached zero before he turned it back to vacuum. The air inside the antechamber still contains some humidity and oxygen that could pollute the glove box's atmosphere. Nick isn't letting the pressure equalize between the two spaces, so the net movement of gas is actually toward the antechamber, preventing any bad air from making its way back into the glove box. Your goal is to perform 3 of these evacuation and refill cycles. Once that's done, you can open the door and bring in your stuff. Let's watch Nick open the antechamber from the inside. First, notice that the vacuum gauge shows the antechamber is at atmospheric pressure. At this point, Nick is ready to open the inner door. Turn the doorknob counterclockwise a full turn so that it can move freely, then pull the door upwards off of both support posts. This is different from how the outer door works. Nick is now setting the door down in a very specific way though. The knob is down with the metal plate facing upwards. This is great technique, and let me tell you why. The antechamber door makes a seal with rubber O-ring that goes around the end of the cylinder. The glove box can be a really dirty place, and setting the door face down means that glass or dirt or crud could get transferred onto the plate right where the O-ring needs to touch. This could damage the O-ring or prevent it from making a seal, and that means the chamber won't hold vacuum. Once you've brought in your materials, close up the antechamber, turn the doorknob clockwise until it's firm but not too tight, and then evacuate the chamber to make sure the doors are sealed properly before moving the knob back to the neutral position. The cycle is complete.